Let me tell you about our boat. Conqueror is a fishing trawler built in North Carolina by master carpenter Norman C. Bellamy. It's certified for 108 passengers, which is probably about what they had on the Mayflower. The design is known as a massive frame wooden vessel built at the end of the wood boat age using all that know-how. Briefly used for fishing, it changed hands to a married couple who sailed around the world twice and hopefully stayed married. There is a rumor that it was used for drug smuggling in the early 80s and seized by federal marshals, but they must have taken the drugs with them because we looked. It was sold at auction and eventually sailed through the Panama Canal, where a diehard ocean explorer and Newport Beach intellectual, Mr. Willard May, dedicated it to youth science. For 30 years, it remained in the service of ocean education. His goal to create a learning lab at sea was successful, and over the years, 100,000 kids enjoyed their first ocean adventure aboard this boat. Many discovered a new species, which was the core of his program. Last year, Conqueror was purchased by Drive Around the World, that's us, to be used in an exciting new program that extends a legacy of learning to cultivate a new generation of ocean explorers. We are Driving Science at Sea. So, that's the name of the program. The program is targeting 5th through 8th grade, maybe even high school. And we'll offer it to any school wishing to take part in STEM or STEAM, or field and stream education. That last one isn't a thing, I just made it up. Okay, to the boat. Wow, look at that boat. Wait, is that a boat or a ship? Well, technically, it's a ship. What's important is, we can have up to 60 students on board, or about 2 average-sized classrooms, plus all the necessary crew, educators, and experts to stay safe and support them. And what will they be doing? Well, something educational, of course, and insanely cool. We're taking students out to sea to deploy underwater ROVs, stands for remote operated vehicle, a sea drone, if you will, and get this, they get to build them. The aft salon is where real discovery begins. These are the control stations where students drive something they built underwater and see what the cameras see. Up to 8 ROVs in the water at the same time, with 8 teams driving them here in shifts. This station is for the underwater explorers. They're looking for a shipwreck using a sector scan sonar device. Once they identify the wreck, they'll plan a traverse through it and form a hypothesis for how it sank. Ocean science and marine biology are over here. They attach the specimen and water sample collectors to their ROV, along with critter catcher trawl nets and other scientific gadgets like a handy manipulator arm to, you know, manipulate stuff. Here's ocean engineering. There's a special gauge on their ROV that measures the thickness of the El Segundo pipeline. They measure from flange to flange and from the seafloor to the bottom of the pipe in several areas to help determine if it's sinking into the seabed. After lunch, they'll survey a site for an underwater restaurant. Okay, this is a deployment station. 2 members of each team lower the ROV into the water and control the tether reel. It's a lifeline, so it doesn't get lost. We're a ways off from a wireless underwater link, so the commands and signals come from this neutrally buoyant yellow bundle of wires that control the thrusters, cameras, and all the special equipment doodads. These students will keep an eye on their team's ROV and eventually switch places with the control crew to log some drive time or operate the instruments. This 7,000-pound sea crane can lift anything, as long as it's less than 7,000 pounds. Its main use is for hauling up seabed sediments using a Van Veen grab sampler, which is a fun word combination to say. Van Veen grab sampler. Try it later, you'll love it. Those sediments are deposited here into this 100-gallon specimen tank for up-close science-ing. There's always something interactive happening back here. Not all kids want to be scientists. Some will look to the ocean for profit. The underwater film and photography team controls from here. Equipped with extra cameras and a lighting package, they document the other teams above and below the waterline for a video tale of each excursion that everyone gets to keep. And here is Team Serendipity. We never know what those kids are going to do, which is the point, actually. ROVs are pretty useful for ocean cleanup, and we give an award for the best piece of trash collected. Here's the engine room. Twin Caterpillar six-cylinder turbo diesels give us a steady 13 knots. The walls on either side of the engines are actually fuel tanks that hold 5,600 gallons, which I calculated can get us to Hawaii. Ah, glad to see they're still married. Back to the main deck. The forward salon is our chillax and chow down space. Here, teams on deck can work on their ROVs, add equipment, make repairs, or grab a meal from the galley, generously provided by Enterprise Fish Company, Santa Monica's finest fish company. Legally, we have to say that, but it happens to be true. On boats, you have to make good use of space. So, here is Captain Zoltar, a crusty fortune teller who dispenses one of 100 positive affirmation cards for students to keep. Each one encourages a role in ocean preservation, and they're written really well. Also, our team wrote them. Practically every wall has a 4K screen. Some flip between sections of the ship, showing radar, sonar data, and so on. This screen contains the schedule for who's deploying. Looks like Team Waterworld is on deck. Yes, a group of teenage kids are paying homage to a 25-year-old Kevin Costner movie. This monitor shows a split screen with feeds from 8 of our ROVs. It's cool to see the ROVs zipping by now and then. This one has the most realistic virtual aquarium ever created. It's nice to see what the other teams are doing. This monitor shows a split screen with feeds from 4 of our ROVs. The one next to it has the other 4. That's right, 8 ROVs in the water at the same time. Topside. When students aren't deploying, they're taking part in interactive TED-type talks, or just enjoying the ocean. Lots of unscheduled time to just take it all in and enjoy the largest habitat on Earth. We pay a freelance day rate to an accredited marine scientist and ocean engineer, who serve as guides and guest speakers. Here's the helm. We pay a captain and 3 crew, and, unlike our past programs that were 100% volunteer, everyone involved in driving science at sea gets paid. It just works better that way. The ship was Coast Guard certified for decades, so it has all the required equipment. 130 life vests, plenty of lifeboats, all checked as part of regular maintenance and inspections, though some of it needs to be repaired, refurbished, or replaced, which, if you haven't guessed by now, is why we're showing this to you. Hey, there's my house. You probably want to see where we're going. Our deployment sites are close, just 2 miles due south of the harbor. We visited and GPS marked 2 sites that feature rich reefs, lots of marine life, shipwrecks, and underwater pipelines at a depth of 10 to 22 fathoms. That's 60 to 130 feet. But we talk fathoms around here. Sites are close to the harbor, so ROVs are in the water within 30 minutes. There's even a backup site inside the marina that minimizes weather-related scrubs. Nothing worse for an 11-year-old than a canceled field trip. The program begins weeks before the ocean expedition, when our advanced team visits a participating school. We deliver 8 underwater ROV kits, along with a 3D printer, and a brief orientation that takes students through assembly and operation. All students join a deployment team, 4 students per team, and they receive specialized gear to equip each ROV for one of 8 underwater missions. It takes a few hours to assemble the ROV, and we feel strongly that the students themselves handle the assembly, so they experience the satisfaction of collaboratively building, testing, and deploying within a team. Also, they can fix anything that breaks. And by the time they come aboard, they're already familiar with the ROV. Maybe they've named it. I named mine Steve Z. Once they're ready, they'll come aboard and deploy a science instrument they collaboratively built with their friends for an up-close look at a different world. What they encounter will blow their minds. About us? Well, we are drive around the world, creators of relevant adventures. Our team did this with these, and this with these. And each project we take on is for a different cause. This was for Parkinson's disease research and made a well-received series on National Geographic Channel. A couple of drives around the planet has a way of turning you into a crusader. So we started thinking big and spent 7 years building 2 of these. They're, wait for it, electric Hummers that scientists will use at the bottom of the planet to get us some answers. Doing climate science out of the back of a Hummer. That's poetic. One of them tows a 1962 Airstream with skis, which is where we live when on the ice, because why would anyone pitch a tent in minus 60 when you can be glamping? We are planning a program that will serve for decades, because frankly, it needs to. Just look around. Isn't it obvious our students, our planet, and our future depend on people who care? People willing to set bold plans into motion. So come on, what's left to talk about? Let's enable them. At introductory levels, okay, let's see, sharpening the pencil here. 60 students times 3 excursions per week, 30 weeks out of the year equals 5,400 students who will benefit from this program each year. And we'll reach 15,000 once the operation is in full swing. $350,000 gets the program started and funds it for 1 year. $1.5 million allows us to go for 5 years and includes a complete remodel of the boat that you see here. Drive Around the World is a 501c3 nonprofit, in good standing since 2002. So all monetary gifts are tax deductible. But please know, we have no way of getting your kids into college. We have lots of local support from our friends at West Marine and from the ROV manufacturer, Blue Robotics. I already mentioned the fish company. We can seek grants once we're operational, but they can be hard to get for something new. So right now we need your support to get the project started. We saw something we could do to make a difference. And we're going for it. We made the bold move to buy this great ship, got it cleaned up and operational, and now we're asking for your help. We are placing a strong foundation beneath Driving Science at Sea, made up of supporters who are as bold and program proud as we are. The opportunity to support this project is the opportunity. It's that simple. And with that, we invite you to watch this ship sail by with its decks filled with bright-eyed and curious young explorers and say, I enable that. Driving Science at Sea is well-defined. So, like Walt Disney used to say, let's keep moving forward. Together, we'll watch it evolve, and don't be surprised when someday a piece of legislation to save 100 miles of coastline is written by someone who, as a kid, built an underwater ROV to explore the ocean.